Welcome to lesson two of our Forms 101 course. In this video, we'll get an overview of the different types of fields that we can use in our forms. We'll also learn how to create multi-step forms or forms that have multiple pages. Let's get right into it. Start by clicking Edit on a form. If you've not created a form, click Get Started and then go through the Add Form page and you'll end up here on the Form Builder page. First, let's look at the different fields you can use. If you're using the Lite plan, you'll have access to the standard Shopify fields and to the display fields. Standard fields are fields that come with a typical Shopify customer record. They cover some of the basic information that you'll probably ask for from your customers. Now, most of these are self-explanatory, but one I want to mention is Accepts Marketing. Accepts Marketing is a single checkbox field with a label that says subscribe to our newsletter. If this field is checked, then the app will automatically mark the customer as subscribed to marketing in Shopify. This field can also be used to allow existing customers to unsubscribe from marketing when they update their account. Now, this Accepts Marketing is especially useful if you're using another app for marketing, since most marketing apps for Shopify rely on this particular field to determine if the customer can be sent emails or text messages. The next vertical tab contains various address fields. These fields will update the default address field in the customer's Shopify record. I want to talk about three fields in this section that deserve some attention: country, state or province, and phone number. Country brings up a drop-down selector with various countries. This field's drop-down options are automatically determined based on your store's shipping zones. However, if you want to show more options, you can check Show All Countries. Next is the state or province field. The options shown depend on the selection of the country field. If you don't have a country field on the form, then there will be a new setting for default country within the state or province field that allows you to control what options are shown in the dropdown. Now, this phone number field in the address tab is different from the phone number field in the standard or custom input field tabs. An address phone number is specifically for recording a phone number attached to a default address in Shopify. The address phone number can be the same as the primary phone number on any other account, and it doesn't have to be unique. Next are various display fields. Each of these can help build out your form's design and functionality. You can add headings, text, links, images, custom HTML, or create dividers between form sections to break up content. And at the bottom of the vertical tabs, we have custom input fields. And there is so much you can do with custom fields that our next video is just dedicated to this section. We also have a detailed help article about each field, and I've linked that in the description. Adding fields from any of these tabs is as simple as dragging and dropping. Once a field is on the form, you can drag them around to change the order. If you want fields to be on the same row next to each other, drag a field over to the left or right of another field, and they'll now be side by side. Another powerful tool in your customer fields tool belt is the ability to add form steps. It's a simple way to add layers to your form so that customers don't feel overwhelmed. Let's look at a quick example first. Here's a style quiz for a clothing subscription store. With these steps, we're able to break up the various parts of the questionnaire to streamline the customer experience. Now let's go back to the form editor. From here, we simply click Edit Form Steps. We can then add a form step, name it, add any other steps we'd like, and hit Save. Adding fields to this form step is easy. Click on the new step at the top of the menu and bring over new fields, or return back to the first step and drag a field over. So we reviewed the different types of fields at your disposal, and how to move them around, and how to create form steps. You should be well on your way to creating unique forms that help you gather powerful customer insights. In the next lesson, we'll go through each of the 14 custom fields. I'll catch you in the next video. Thanks for watching.